So for me, sound and music is one of the most important things. It's how I escape. If I'm going for a run or whatever, you can listen to music and it kind of removes you from, you know, the monotony of life, which is it's pretty special. My dad was an electronics engineer, so I was constantly surrounded by electronics, changing plugs at the age of 3. So as I grew up, I started doing audio engineering with my dad. I was just fortunate enough to get into the industry to take kind of both of my loves of engineering, electronics, music, and then, you know, putting them together. Vox started off just, you know, a couple of guys making some amps, and then in the 60s, Vox really took off because they gave a load of amps to a band that no one had ever heard of called the Beatles. At that point, they became a bit of a global phenomenon and Vox came along with that too. Vox has its own unique sound, and what makes us different is a couple of circuit topologies which, when they were designed, didn't really exist elsewhere. The key thing is a no negative feedback loop in the power amp. And what that means, you get some amazing distortion. The other thing that we're really famous for is the classic Vox chime. And the Vox chime is this kind of just really high-end, sparkly sound. And there's no one else that can do it like this. So. Me and my team, we have complete ownership of the product from concept all the way through to final design. And it kind of gives you that full ownership, which is really fantastic because you're really invested in what you've done. When you're designing tube amplifiers, you have to be very careful about clearances because of high voltages and things like that. So one of the really powerful things that we can use it for is actually to use these rules and allocate these rules to specific nets. So we want that net, knowing that's a high voltage, to have a minimum of 1 millimeter clearance. And you can do this on a net by net basis, which is really useful rather than having to do it through the PCB and not knowing necessarily which are the high voltage nets. You can actually do it through the schematics and pass those rules directly to the online design rules checker on the PCB. When I was demonstrated Altium Designer, that's kind of the thing that stood out for me, is the fact it just worked. I didn't have multiple screens and multiple programs open. I had one unified environment that did everything I needed, whether that was simulation, whether that was schematic design, whether that was PCB design, everything was there. And for me, that was the main draw, and yeah, I haven't really looked back since, if I'm honest. This was designed a limited edition for our 60th anniversary, and we made this in the UK. And as you can see, it's completely hand-wired, no PCBs whatsoever. But don't let it fool you, because this was designed entirely in Altium Designer. From the schematics to the simulations to every single turret board was designed with Altium Designer. Wiring diagrams, everything. So even though Altium Designer is super high tech, we were still able to repurpose it and make stuff that looks like very, very old and things like that. But as you can see, it's more of an art form. You know, there's no need for us to do it like this, but you know, look at it, it looks great. But going from that to something like this, which is our mini Super Beetle. And this is a 50 watt guitar amp. It's kind of fun that we're able to, you know, use Altium Designer to design things like this, which has got CPUs in there, this has got built-in reverbs, it's got DSP, Class D power amp, it's got vacuum valves, it's got op amps, it kind of covers the whole audio spectrum as far as, you know, topology is concerned, to this whole thing here, which, you know, is about as simple and back to basics as an amp can possibly be. So Altium Designer really can be used for both things. In 2016, I went to my first Glastonbury. I went with a whole bunch of old school friends I hadn't seen for years, and they said, well, what is it you do? We were at the pyramid stage, and there was a band playing on the stage, and one of my amps was on stage, and I said, well, if you just look to the right-hand side of that guitarist, that amp he's playing. Oh, yeah, I designed that amp. And they were just, what? And I was like, yeah, so that amp and that one over there as well, they're both designs that came out of this office. It was, yeah, completely amazing, to be honest. So the design challenges are always trying to take the old and add in the new, but keeping true to our kind of heritage, you know. So the design challenges that we have will always be, you know, taking something old, keeping our client base happy, but then adding in maybe something under the hood. Maybe they don't even notice it. Maybe that's the best kind of technology. Maybe the technology is completely transparent, but it benefits the product without people even noticing. So that for us is something we're always quite key on doing. Every time we add new technology into something, it always has to have a benefit to the end user. And frankly, if they don't even notice that, that's great because we've done our job. My advice is listen to the senior engineers and learn as much as you can. It's a really fun industry and it's a really fun thing to create because what you're creating is a tool for other people to be creative. So Altium Designer helps me reduce my time to market by about 50%. And frankly, that's why I choose Altium.